In this video, I'll talk about the gas laws and apply one of the gas laws in an example. First, let's talk about the relationship between volume and temperature. And you may have seen this science experiment where a balloon is attached to the top of a bottle, and the bottle then is heated up with some flames or some other hot plate there. And so the temperature is increased, and you can imagine what happens. The balloon, then also the gas in the balloon, wants to expand. The gas molecules or the gas atoms get excited, they move around more, and if we're not changing the pressure, we're not pushing any more in on this balloon, then it wants to expand. So the volume also expands. So we say that the volume is proportional to the temperature. Or mathematically, we say that if we measured the volume and the temperature of some system, they say this balloon, then that ratio would equal the second volume and temperature measured at some later time. So the ratio is the same. Volume and temperature are not the same because we say it's proportional. The units are different. So we can't say volume and temperature are the same, but they are proportional. So one goes up, so does the other. Let's talk about the relationship between pressure and temperature. So now not a balloon, but now let's consider a static glass ball. And in this case, we're going to heat this up. Adding some fire there, but it is static. We will not let the volume increase or decrease. And the temperature is going up. Well, when the temperature goes up, we know that that volume, the gas, gets excited there and things get moving around. And it wants to expand, but it can't. And so what's happening is all of these molecules are hitting the side, hitting the walls much more frequently and faster. And so therefore, the pressure also goes up. So the pressure increases as the temperature increases, and likewise, as the pressure goes down, the temperature decreases. And you may have even witnessed this if you've ever been under the right circumstances. If you you see this all the time. If you spray an aerosol can, you might feel it get colder in your hand, and that is because that quick decrease in pressure also drops the temperature in the can. And so yes, it does feel cold. Then you stop spraying. A little while later, the can warms up just because of the ambient air temperature. And then do this again, spray, a quick decrease in pressure, then decreases the temperature. And that's why that's happening in an aerosol can like that. So we say that pressure is proportional to temperature, or mathematically, P sub 1 over T sub 1. So the pressure and the temperature recorded at one time, the ratio of those will equal the ratio of those recorded at another time. So even if the pressure is different than the initial pressure, then the temperature will have to be different than the initial temperature. Okay, let's talk about this example, and this is going to relate pressure and volume. So pressure, we say, is inversely related to volume. So as the pressure increases, the volume will decrease. So consider this. Consider some sphere. And what we're going to do is take the pressure and increase that pressure. We're going to push in on this sphere. And let's say it's a rubber ball that is filled with a gas. Well, what's going to happen? As we increase the pressure on the outside, then that volume must decrease. We're pushing it closer together, assuming that, of course, that we're keeping the temperature the same. So we push in with the pressure, the volume decreases. Or likewise, if the volume increases, then the pressure must decrease. So mathematically, we say that P sub 1 times V sub 1, some pressure and volume measured initially, will equal P sub 2 multiplied by V sub 2. And when you're multiplying those, you can see if those are equal, then if P increases over here, then the V must decrease to compensate for that, to get the same product. Okay, so let's plug in what we have here. We have an initial volume and an initial pressure. So pressure is initially 1.28 atmospheres. Let me read that out to you. That is, a gas occupying a volume of 645 milliliters at a pressure of 1.28 atmospheres is allowed to expand at constant temperature until its pressure equals 0.865 atmospheres. What is its final volume? So we have, we're just going to plug this in. We have the pressure, the initial pressure, that's P sub 1, and the initial volume, V sub 1, and that is given in 645 milliliters. By the way, if you're dealing with the ideal gas equation, that's PV equals nRT, then volume takes on a specific unit. You can't just do anything you want. But here, with these gas laws, as long as you end with milliliters, you're okay using milliliters or cubic centimeters or cubic inches or cubic feet, really, as long as you stay constant with the, or consistent with the label from V sub 1 to V sub 2. Okay, equals, the second pressure is 0.865, so that is right here, P sub 2, 0.865 atmospheres, times what we don't know, its final volume, V sub 2. Now try to take a guess, is the volume going to be larger or smaller? I assume you paused it to take a guess, and the volume should be larger. That is, we decreased the pressure, so that allowed the volume to expand. And it says the volume is allowed to expand. So we have, solving for this, V sub 2, the resulting volume, rounding to three significant digits, is 954 milliliters. So the volume did increase. I hope that was helpful. As always, if you found this video helpful, consider liking it or sharing it with a friend.